हेलो बच्चों, कैसे हो आप लोग? आज हम लोग क्या पढ़ेंगे? टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी पोरीफेरा, राइट? इट इज अ वेरी इजी टॉपिक. फ्यू क्वेश्चंस कैन बी मेड फ्रॉम इट, बट फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ईच एंड एवरी टॉपिक इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इफ यू वांट टू स्कोर फुल मार्क्स, राइट? वी नीड टू नो अबाउट ईच एंड एवरी टॉपिक. सो पोरीफेरा, about sponges, and what are, when we are talking about porifera, we are talking about sponges. And when we are talking about sponges, what we are talking about, we are talking about some pores, right? Spongy, soft. And so the porifera name came from porous, Greek word, and fera, pore, bear, means so animals that let us see something more about them. So they are sessile aquatic organisms. They can't move and they are mostly marine. So one very common question is name a freshwater porifera, because they are mostly marine. So generally the questions are asked on some exceptions, right? So what is a freshwater porifera or a freshwater sponge? That is a spongula. So you have so they are multicellular. As soon as we say they are multicellular, the question that should come in our mind is, what is the level of organization? They exhibit a cellular level of organization. It means that there is a group of cells, or we can say there is an aggregate of cells, right? And their body plan is what? Cell aggregate type. So it means there is cell aggregate, there is just a cluster of cells, right? And there is no coordination among them, right? So this is important part to remember, that the level of organization is cellular level and the cell aggregate type of body plan. So this is the very basic characteristics that we have done. Now let us see something about symmetry. So what can we say about symmetry? Are they symmetrical? No, they are not symmetrical, and they are mostly, so what can we say if they are not symmetrical? We'll say that they are asymmetrical, right? Some exhibit radial symmetry, but that is just superficially, not internally. And what about coelom? If we say about coelom, they are acoelomates, right? They are acoelomates. They don't have a coelom. And what about germ layers? If you want to ask, sponges lack germ layers, right? Important thing to remember, they lack germ layers, but the body wall has few undifferentiated, some cells, like, you know, the let us see about those cells. So this is a pinacoderm. What is pinacoderm? Pinacoderm is it, you can compare it with the epidermis, right? So you can just compare it with the epidermis. It is what? It has flat and oval cells that are basically the epithelial cells, right? And these cells are known as pinacocytes. These cells are what? These cells are known as pinacocytes. And now let us see about conoderm. What is this conoderm? This is lining of the spongocoel, Now we'll see what is, now we encountered with the new word spongocele. So we have to see what is spongocele. When we are saying lining of the spongocele, and they are, why are they called conoderm? Because they have specialized cells called collar cells or conocytes. Conocytes. So why are they called collar cells? Because these cells are something like this, with a whip-like flagella, right? So this is what? This is a collar. And this is what? This is the flagella, which beats, and many other functions will happen because of this conocytes or conoderm. So now between these, if this is the, suppose this is a sponge, right? And these are the conocytes, right? With the, with their flagella, and these are the pinacocytes, right? These are the pinacocytes, and they are like you one layered, okay? They are flattened oval epithelial cells, right? So the area in between them that we see, this is called what? This is the mesohyal. Or initially it was called mesenchyme or mesoglia. So this area we are talking about is the mesohyal, mesenchyme or mesoglia. So now let us see what is this mesohyal. Basically, it is something like a gelatinous matrix, right? It is a gelatinous matrix. Secondly, it is between pinacoderm and conoderm, as we can see. What is other thing we should know about? It has many amoeboid cells. We will see about each of these amoeboid cells. These amoeboid cells are known as amoebocytes. They have many amoebocytes in them. And what are these amoebocytes? We will see about these amoebocytes in detail. Now, first we need to understand what is it made up of? What is the composition of this mesohyal, right? So basically it is formed of some polypeptides, right? Like polymers of proteins, and they are what? They are basically collagen and galactin and dermatopontin. So these are the three words that you can remember. So they are these polypeptides which form the mesohyal. They are collagen, galactin, dermatopontin, right? So you have to remember this. What do these polypeptides do? They form an extracellular matrix for the sponges, right? And what does this extracellular matrix does? It helps in basically three things, right? It is helping in basically three things. Cell adhesion to where? To the base, to one another, and cellular growth. And signal transduction. Signal transduction. What is signal transduction? Because these two words are easy to understand. Signal transduction is basically a process by which a chemical or a physical signal. So in which what in signal, what kind of signals? They can be chemical or physical signals are transmitted through a molecular process. So this is what we are talking about. So basically what you need to remember very nicely is that it is a gelatinous matrix. First point, this mesohyal, it is between pinacoderm and conoderm. It contains many amoeboid cells, which are known as amoebocytes. And all the amoebocytes will do, and you have to remember them. And the composition, they are made up of polypeptides. What are those polypeptides? Collagen, galactin, and dermatopontin. What is this polypeptide doing? It is giving it an extracellular matrix, right? Now let us see something about these amebocytes. What are these amebocytes that we are talking about that we say are present in the mesohyoid, that is the gelatinous matrix, right? So we are going to talk about amebocytes. And this is very important, and you should know each and every amebocytes in what is the function of each and every amebocytes, right? So the first one is archaeocyte. And what are these archaeocytes? These are basically totipotent cells. It is a very famous and a very favorite question of the paper setter. Archaeocytes, that name the totipotent cells in porifera. So archaeocytes are the totipotent cells. It means what? It means that they are undifferentiated. Why are they undifferentiated? So that they can give rise to other cells. They're undifferentiated and with a large nucleus, undifferentiated archaeocytes with a large nucleus, and they can produce what? They can produce any other type of cells, right? So these are very important cells that you should know, archaeocytes. Now let us see the other one. They are trophocytes. Now we'll ask, what are trophocytes? So trophocytes, you have to remember that these cells provide, trophocytes are also called nurse cells. You remember this, trophocytes, nurse cells, and you will remember their function, because what does the nurse do to the patient? It provides what? It provides food. So basically it is doing what? It is providing, it provides food to developing cells. Okay, you just have to remember the name with their functions. Now let us see what are colincytes, right? What are colincytes? Whenever we see the word colon, we can easily understand that is something related to fibers. So it secretes fibers, and which forms a net where? In the mesohyoid, right? Colincytes. Now let us see lophocytes. What are these lophocytes? They are similar to colincytes, but they secrete fibers to form skeletal material. So they are similar to colincytes, but they do what? They secrete fibers like colincytes, which form the skeletal material, right? Now let us see about gland cells. What are these gland cells? Gland cells kya secrete karenge? They will secrete mucus, digestive juices. Okay. Now let us see something about thesocytes. What are thesocytes? If we see thesocytes, they store food granules. Okay, they store food granules. So basically you have to write and remember each of them. Scleroblast, they are abundant in mitochondria. Inme mitochondria bahut hota hai, and they have small vacuoles, and they secrete what? They secrete the skeletal material. And what is this skeletal material? They can be in form of calcareous spicules, that is formed of calcium carbonate, or siliceous spicules. We'll do this in detail, calcareous and siliceous spicules. First, just you know that scleroblasts are the cells that are secreting these calcareous spicules and siliceous spicules. And what are these myocytes doing? They are another kind of amebocytes. They are doing what? Let me not put an arrow because I have not put in any. Myocytes are what? Myo, whenever the word myo comes, it is related to muscles, since they don't have muscles. So they must be performing some function of muscle. What is the function of muscle? Contraction and relaxation. So these are what? These are contractile and elongated. And they will do what? They will regulate what? They will regulate what? Since their contraction and relaxation, I told porifive pores, they're pore-bearing animals. So they will regulate the closing and opening of the pores, right? And in the pores, majorly osculum. We'll see what is osculum and major canals. So this is what is doing myocyte. And then we have to see what is phagocytes doing. What are phagocytes doing? Phagocytes, it's very easy to understand. These cells will do what? These cells will engulf food, waste, and damaged tissues using their what? What is very important in phagocytes? Pseudopodia. We have done this in smaller classes, pseudopodia, right? So these are phagocytes, and then very important cells, germ cells, and they can be what? They will mature to form what? By the cells spermatocytes and ova, that is oocytes, right? So this is what you, it's very important, and you need to know this in detail, right? So we have done what? We have done just the basic structure and the basic characteristics of porifera. So what were the basic characteristics of porifera? That they are pore-bearing animals, right? Porous, they are sessile, they cannot move, they are immobile, aquatic organisms, they are mostly marine. But spongula is a very important example of what? It is a very important example of freshwater porifera. They are multicellular aquatic organisms. So they are multicellular. And what is the level of organization? Cellular level. What is their body plan? Cell aggregate. Basically, there is a cluster of cells with no coordination. They are asymmetrical, very important. Acoelomates, very important. They lack germ layers. What is pinacoderm? This is the outer layer that is acting like an epidermis. And these cells are known as pinacocytes, right? What is conoderm? This is the lining of spongocoel. And what is spongocoel? I think I have not told you. This is the spongocoel. And there are many pores in it. So there will be like it is known as spongocoel. So this conoderm, you can see this is lining, this conoderm is lining the spongocoel, right? And these are collar cells or conocytes because they have this collar, right? And a whip-like flagella. Now, between these two layers is mesohyle. That is a gelatinous matrix, and it has many amoebocytes, and it is made up of collagen, galactin, and dermatopontin. And what are the amoebocytes? One is this totipotent cells that are archaeocytes. Then we have these trophocytes that are nurse cells that are providing food. Collencytes are secreting fibers that form a net in the mesohyle. Lophocytes are similar to collencytes, but they're secreting fibers that form the skeletal material. Gland cells secrete mucus and digestive juices. Thesocytes, the name is a little different, you have to remember it. They store food granules. Scleroblast, they have a lot of mitochondria, and they secrete skeletal material in the form of calcareous spicules or siliceous spicules. Myocytes is doing what? They are contractile and elongated, first point, and they're regulating the closing and opening of the pores, especially osculum and major canals. What is the phagocytes doing? It is engulfing food, damaged tissues and waste through their pseudopodia. What is a germ cell doing? The mature germ cells will develop into sperms and ova. So this is the basic characteristics of phylum Porifera. In the next, we are going to do the canal system and the reproduction part, okay?